Even though there are 10 games tonight in Daily Fantasy Baseball, there are no surefire aces who we know can rack up 10, 12 strikeouts on a given night on this slate. The one guy who gets the most strikeouts in a pretty tough matchup. So I would say it's a pretty wide open slate of pitcher. And I do think there are guys I prefer, but there's not anything where there is an obvious chalk player you need to avoid, stuff like that, which I think is a pretty fun slate. You can kind of follow your instincts, for me, follow my projections, and decide what I feel best about. We'll break down where I'm leaning for tonight, which guys I like, why I'm there, and also the top stacking options for today across Major League Baseball. Welcome on into the Solo Shot. That's right here on the FanDuel Podcast Network and NumberFire.com. My name is Jim Sonnes. I am a senior writer and analyst for NumberFire. Here to break down Monday's 10-game main slate with lock set for 7.05 p.m. Eastern for today. There are some weather notes on this slate. First off, there is a good chance of rain in Pittsburgh for the Guardians and the Pirates. They look scattered, so they might be able to play through it, but it's worth checking back on later because delays do seem likely there. Rain is also possible in Cincinnati for the Reds and the Giants. Might not arrive until later in the game, so should be good to go there, but worth checking back on that later. It is also very warm in both Baltimore and Kansas City. Temperatures 85, 90 degrees, somewhere in that range. So I'd bump up batters in both those games, which means bump up bats for the Dodgers, Orioles, Tigers, and Royals, and I'll like one of those games quite a bit for stacking. Other one, at least worth considering as well. We'll dive into what all that means, top pitching options, and more in just one second. But first, a reminder to make sure you're subscribed to the NumberFire Daily Fantasy Podcast feed wherever you get your podcasts. If you like what you hear, leave us a 5-star rating on Apple Podcasts for Spotify. Back once again tomorrow with the Open Championship preview via myself and Brandon Gandula. We're going to have that live on the FanDuel YouTube page at noon Eastern. So if you want to watch us live, feel free to bop over there. FanDuel YouTube page, noon Eastern Tuesday, breaking down the Open Championship. Of course, that podcast will be up here on the NumberFire Daily Fantasy Podcast feed as well. And of course, the Solo Shot is available on FanDuel TV Plus on Apple TV, Amazon Fire, and Roku as well. Take your first swing at betting MLB on FanDuel and get 10 times your first bet amount in bonus bets up to $200. That's right. Just bet $20 and you'll land $200 in bonus bets, win or lose. That's $200 you can spend betting everything from the money line to the over-under to who you think is going to hit the first home run, all in an app that is safe, secure, and super easy to use. Plus, when you win, you can get paid instantly. There's no better place to bet on MLB than FanDuel, America's number one sportsbook. So sign up today and get up to $200 in bonus bets. FanDuel, official partner of Major League Baseball, must be 21 plus and present in select states. First online real money wager only. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued is non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 14 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. FanDuel is offering online sports wagering in Kansas under an agreement with Kansas Star Casino LLC. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit FanDuel.com/RG in Colorado, Iowa, Michigan, New Jersey, Ohio, Pennsylvania, Illinois, Tennessee, and Virginia. Call 1-800-NEXT-STEP or text NEXTSTEP to 53342 in Arizona, 1-888-789-7777 or visit ccpg.org/chat in Connecticut, 1-800-9-WITH-IT in Indiana, 1-800-522-4700 or visit ksgamblinghelp.com in Kansas, 1-877-770-STOP in Louisiana. Visit mdgamblinghelp.org in Maryland. Visit 1-800-GAMBLER.net in West Virginia or call 1-800-522-4700 in Wyoming. Hope is here. Visit gamblinghelplinema.org or call 800-327-5050 for 24/7 support in Massachusetts or call 1-877-8-HOPE-NY or text HOPE-NY in New York. Pitching preview for this Monday main slate, Logan Webb checks in with the highest salary on FanDuel. His salary is $10,500, followed by Jesus Luzardo at 10-3. Shane McClanahan coming off the IL at $10,000. Logan Gilbert facing McClanahan is 99. Sonny Gray, actually not facing McClanahan, I lied. McClanahan facing the Rangers. Gilbert facing the Twins, he's 99. He is facing Sonny Gray at $9,600. Mackenzie Gore, 92. Griffin Canning, Dane Dunning, Matt Manning, Emmett Sheehan, Miles Mikolas and Drew Smyly are the others at $8,000 or higher. Now, with McClanahan being banged up and Lizardo facing the Cardinals, there are no super, super high strikeout guys on this slate. That means to me, we can feel better going at the best real-world pitcher on the slate. And to me, the best real-world pitcher right now is Logan Webb. He's facing the Reds, and that's a team that can obviously do a lot of fun stuff, but I still like Webb enough to go at him here. Webb's having another phenomenal season. He has a 3.14 ERA in the first half, and he combines great batted ball data with enough strikeouts to be viable on certain slates for DFS. 25% strikeout rate for the full season. Now, if there's a slate where there is an Ohtani, high strikeout guys, Spencer Strider, stuff like that, we might not get to Webb. But on this one, the competition for strikeouts, not as tough. And Webb actually ranks second in my strikeout projections on this slate. And that's high enough, especially because of what he does in other categories. He has a 3.28 skill interactive ERA across 14 starts since he started throwing more changeups, with a 23% fly ball rate. Now, this Reds offense is tricky. They're calling up another top prospect today, so getting even trickier. But 101 WRC plus means we probably don't need to avoid them just yet. They do draw walks. They do cause havoc on the base paths, but Webb doesn't issue a lot of walks, so I feel good about him here. 10.5 is definitely not a low salary, but I think we can live with that on this slate. So I like Webb quite a bit, and we'll rank him number one for tonight in MLB DFS. I mentioned in there that Webb is going to be number two in my strikeout projections. The guy in first is Jesus Luzardo, and his matchup scares me a bit more, which is why I'm not going to Luzardo for cash games and not going to put him first for tournaments, but I will put him number two because I do like his upside. He's facing the Cardinals. They have a lot of guys who can crush lefties. Their WRC plus against lefties this year is 106, which is okay. It's pretty good, but I think it might go up, and I would take the over on that number for the rest of this year. But it's low enough where I think it does give us a green light to consider Luzardo for tournaments. And Luzardo is pitching very well. Across 19 starts, he has a 29% strikeout rate with a 3.38 skill interactive ERA. Basically, he is replicating what he did last year during his big breakout. Similar to a lot of Marlins pitchers, Luzardo does have a tougher time on the road than at home, and he is on the road here. And that's another reason to favor Logan Webb over Luzardo. Webb also on the road, but Luzardo splits a bit more concerning. But the strikeout rate for Luzardo is still really good on the road. Luzardo, I haven't projected for 6.6 strikeouts tonight, which is number one on the slate, just ahead of Logan Webb. His salary is 10.3. I am going to go Webb first because I like the run prevention expectation more than I like Lizardo's, but I still think both these guys are going to be fun plays. Luzardo tournaments only, Webb a consideration for cash games, but both these guys to me really solid options for tonight. Looking at our value play for today, we're going to go towards the guy who got blasted in his final start before the All-Star break, and Griffin Canning. We lasted just 2 2/3 innings and let up 4 earned runs, but he's at home taking on the Yankees tonight, and assuming Aaron Judge is not miraculously activated without a rehab stint, I think Canning is going to be the top value play on tonight's slate. Now, that one bad outing does matter, but I also think it's kind of an outlier. For the most part, Canning has been pitching pretty well before that time. His velo has been stable now for his past 10 starts, and his ERA in that time is 4.36, including that bad outing, which is not amazing, but it's also not terrible. The peripherals for Canning are a bit better. He has a 3.94 skill interactive ERA with a 24% strikeout rate. He is letting up too much hard contact, but this Yankees active roster in its current state, just an 80 WRC plus against righties. They're not hitting for a ton of power. You're taking them out of Yankee Stadium for tonight as well. Canning can have strikeout upside. He had 9 strikeouts twice in his past 10 starts, again, including that clunker there with the velo stabilized. And he had 7 in 2 others. In this specific matchup, I think Canning has upside. His salary here is $8,800, so I am very willing to put Canning in my player pool. I think that the strikeout upside is there. I think that the safety, good enough despite that one bad start, where I feel okay about Canning. So to me, it's kind of Canning in the same tier as Webb and Luzardo, because both those guys are on the road. Both those guys have some sort of concern, whether it be park factor, matchup, whatever it may be. Canning gets good stuff there. He's at home. Just in a, you know, not quite as well-rounded pitcher right now. So I do like Canning enough to use him. Think he's in the same tier as Luzardo and Webb, and feel good enough about Canning for tonight to be on him over on FanDuel. So again, top two pitchers are Webb and Luzardo, and the top value play will be Griffin Canning for tonight. Let's move now to the stacks and actually stick in that exact same game. And might be curious why we're stacking the Angels, given they're missing Mike Trout, no Brandon Drury, no Anthony Rendon. They're pretty decimated right now, but the guys who are there are still hitting the ball pretty well. And they're facing Luis Severino. And Severino is someone who can turn it around at any moment because he is a good pitcher, but he's not pitching well right now. And that's always a recipe where he could click at any moment and suddenly turn things around. But he's facing the Angels tonight, and I think that we should be willing to stack them in this matchup. Severino has made 9 starts since coming back. His ERA is 7.38. His skill interactive ERA is 5.05, and his expected ERA is 7 flat. Severino's not getting many strikeouts, and he's letting up a ton of hard contact, so that's one thing. But I think it's his pitch mix that, to me, is the biggest red flag. Over his past 5 starts, Severino has been throwing fewer sliders than he threw when he first came back off the IL, and even that number was lower than where he was at last year. And the reason that's concerning is that that was a really good pitch for him last year, and that pitch is getting crushed right now. So I get why he's scaling back on it, but I'm not sure if he's afraid to use it because the damage is done, if he's not just feeling it right now, whatever it may be, it does hurt my faith that Severino can quickly turn things around. Angels, even without those guys, are a pretty tough test. They still got Shohei Ohtani, Mickey Moniak's playing really well. Some of their fill-ins have played respectable enough. So I think the Angels are a good stack, despite the fact they have lost so many key batters. I do still feel good about them for today. So the Angels, to me, a quality stack, taking on Severino until we get reason to think Severino's turned things around. So Severino getting rocked by both righties and lefties, so I don't care, righty-lefty. Feel like you just go at the best batters here. And to me, the best batters are Shohei Ohtani, obviously one, and Mickey Moniak, number two. Moniak getting more playing time with Mike Trout out. He's playing really well to earn that playing time, keep on getting it. So I'm more than willing to buy in. So I know it's weird to stack the Angels with how many guys are missing, but I do feel good about here and will feel okay stacking the Angels against Severino for tonight. For our number 2 and number 3 stacks, we're going to go at the same game. It's one of those games with the good hitting weather. That one is in Baltimore for the Dodgers and the Orioles. Both these teams facing young, pretty fun pitchers, Nemeth Sheehan and Grayson Rodriguez, but neither guy in a great groove right now, so I think we should look to stack both sides of this game. I prefer the Dodgers, so we'll start with them, but we'll talk about the Orioles after that. The Dodgers are facing Grayson Rodriguez, who's coming back up from AAA for this game, and he pitched really well down there. Across 8 starts in AAA across the entire year, Rodriguez has a 1.96 ERA with a 33% strikeout rate. That is really good stuff. But Rodriguez still walking a lot of guys, and the strikeouts when he was in the majors were not the issue. He was getting strikeouts there. It was the walks, and it was the hard contact. Now, across 10 starts, Rodriguez let up a 52% hard hit rate in the majors. In AAA, that number is 32%. So maybe he's fixed it. Maybe he had some bad luck in that 10-start sample. Whatever it may be, the Dodgers tonight will be a very good test of whether Rodriguez has actually turned things around in that regard. They have a 117 WRC plus against righties with a 206 ISO and a 10% walk rate. If it weren't for the weather, I might not go here, because the weather is definitely a big factor of the being so warm, good for hitting. But I do think there is enough here. Rodriguez is talented. The AAA numbers are very good. I'm encouraged by those. But with it being so hot and the Dodgers being so good, I do think we can stack the Dodgers here. The key question whenever stacking the Dodgers is whether you can trust the value in the lower part of the order. Those guys are David Peralta, Jason Hayward, James Outman, all of lower salaries. And it can make it easier to get to Mookie Betts if you use one or two of those guys. Honestly, I'm on board with all of them. Hayward may not play because he's a little bit banged up right now at a stinger. Peralta hasn't hit for a ton of power, but 155 ISO against righties is fine, I would say. Good enough to consider. Hayward is a 218 if he plays. His ISO against righties. Outman I'd rank lowest of this group because he has not been able to regain his early season form, but he can steal bases too, so he's not totally out of play. I'd rank these guys, if they all play, Hayward 1, Peralta 2, Outman 3, but fine with any of them. Again, most skeptical of Outman. Hopefully Hayward plays, but I think that we do have the green light in general to turn to those value plays if we want help getting to the studs in this lineup. Other side of this game is the Orioles. They're facing Emmett Sheehan, who had a great debut for the Dodgers, but has cooled off since then. And I think that's probably more in line with what we should expect going forward. We're up to four starts on Sheehan. He has a 20% strikeout rate with a 10% swinging strike rate. He did get more strikeouts in AA, but that's AA batters instead of big leaguers. And the sample in the big leagues is big enough now to put stock in, specifically with that swinging strike rate. It's a bit low, about 10%. Again, that's not overwhelming is what I would say. And also Sheehan is a huge fly ball guy, letting up a 55% fly ball rate in the majors. It was 44% in AA, let up a couple home runs in one of his starts, and that's with three of his four starts coming at home. Now, he did do well at Coors Field, so kudos to him there, but that's also a really bad offense in the Rockies. The Orioles, not a bad offense. 110 WRC plus against righties, 183 ISO, 41% fly ball rate. I think people like Sheehan, which may allow the Orioles to be not too popular. There is some interest in their money line. It's been moving in their favor, which I agree with recently, but I do still think that even if the Orioles don't wind up being undervalued, I still think that they are a team we can feel good about stacking for today, and I will stack them in this spot. Want to talk about Gunnar Henderson? His salary is back down to $3,000, which is delightful, but he's still playing really well. 272 ISO against righties. He does strike out too much, which means he can have bad streaks like the one he had a couple weeks ago, but, you know, and he could struggle against a guy like Sheehan who can get some strikeouts. But he can also put up 50 FanDuel points, which is pretty tough to find. So $3,000 to me is too low for Henderson. I feel very good about that and will be high on him here. So Henderson to me, with that salary coming back down, very much back on the menu for DFS, whether it be as a one-off or as part of an Orioles stack within this game here. Let's go now to things to watch. Do you want to touch on Logan Gilbert briefly? Because he's at home in a high strikeout matchup with the Twins. And that's a good situation for him. And it could put him in play, but he's not getting a lot of strikeouts recently. And the Twins' active roster has a 110 WRC plus against righties, despite the number of strikeouts they get. So I don't blame you if you want to go with Gilbert, because he can rack up some strikeouts in this matchup. But I just prefer Webb and Lizardo personally, given I feel better about their form entering tonight. I do think you could consider some Royals batters on this slate. They're facing Matt Manning, who has really struggled with batted balls, but hasn't hurt him yet. ERA is under four. The Royals offense stinks, which is why they're not a higher, but it's a good matchup, good environment for batting tonight. So the Royals at least worth putting on your radar as hitters. I also don't need the Giants. I actually like the Giants more than the Royals. Not sure why I didn't put them above the Royals in this order, but anyway, regardless, like the Giants more. They're facing Brandon Williamson, who has made really good strides recently. His velo is up across his past five starts, and it's really helped his peripherals quite a bit. But the Giants, pretty solid offense against lefties. Great park for hitting as well, so definitely willing to give them a look. So the Giants, to me, the top alternative to those other stacks if you're not as high on the Orioles or the Dodgers. If you feel like you saw something in Severino recently where you want to avoid the Angels, I would go Giants as the next team on my list. Let's finish up here with some dinger calls for today. The boring one is Shohei Ohtani. I get an excuse to talk about Shohei Ohtani on this show. I'm going to take it. Good matchup here with Severino. A lot of hard contact recently. Enough fly balls as well. And it's Shohei Ohtani. I could have gone Moniak if I wanted to be less boring, but I don't. So we're going to go Shohei Ohtani as the boring home run call for today. For the fun one, let's go Ryan O'Hearn. I know the Orioles have called up a lot of fun young guys, so it's weird to talk about Ryan O'Hearn, but he's been pretty good, hitting for a lot of power since he came up for the Orioles. Seven home runs, pretty good overall numbers. I've kept him in the order enough for me to expect him to play for tonight. I know if you go to FanDuel, he's not in the projected starting lineup, but I think he will play. And good situation for hitting. A lot of fly balls allowed by Sheehan. So we'll go with Shohei Ohtani and Ryan O'Hearn as our two home run calls for today. That's all we got for today on the Solo Shot. But as mentioned, we are back once again tomorrow with not just the Solo Shot, but also the heat check for the Open Championship. Make sure you get both those by subscribing to the Number Fire Daily Fantasy Podcast feed or checking out the Solo Shot over on the FanDuel YouTube page or on FanDuel TV Plus. And again, Open Championship preview will be live on the FanDuel YouTube page at noon Eastern. If you've got any questions for me, I am on Twitter at Jim Sonnes, J-I-M-S-A-N-N-E-S. You can also follow the FanDuel Podcast Network at FanDuel Podcasts. Want to thank you all for tuning in for today. Good luck to you with your MLB DFS lineups. We'll talk to you once again tomorrow for Tuesday's slate. This has been the Solo Shot right here on the FanDuel Podcast Network.